I'm Zoey Vianna, and today I'm going to give you my unsolicited makeup routine. Highly unsolicited, as a matter of fact. Ooh, did you hear my shoulder blade just snap? I'm here to give you all my tips for being beautiful and rich and expensive, because obviously I am. I am. Here we go, I guess. I have this little headband. She's so cute. I bought it with good intention, never used it. Had it for like 2 years now. No. We're gonna use it today, since it's a special day. Since Vogue means I have peaked my career, and I'm now rich and famous. You're welcome. I mean, thank you. Oh my gosh. Why do my ears look like that? Sorry if the audio is bad. I've just got this beautiful mansion bathroom, and it's just so echoey in here. And I can't afford a good microphone. So first thing I have is this. Can you see it? She's in her influencer stage. I don't think you can see it at all. It's, oh my gosh, I have to read. My friend actually bought this for me because I don't spend money on things that actually matter. First Aid Beauty Pure Skin Face Cleanser. I like it, it's good. It was $50. It came with other stuff that I don't use because I already have a moisturizer that I like, but it's good. There's really nothing left in here, and I didn't realize that until now. We're gonna make it work, because $50, I don't care if it's 25 cents left, ooh, I'm gonna use that. I can't, oh my gosh. This is good because I have really sensitive skin, and usually everything will irritate it. Even brands that are specifically meant for sensitive skin still end up burning my skin off for some reason. This one also burns if I leave it on too long, but if I like just wash it and then wipe it off right away, usually we're good. Dang, them eyebrows though, look at that, look at that. Also, I know I'm the one giving the tutorial, but like, if anyone knows what product to use to get rid of blackheads, I have so many blackheads on my nose, and I've used all those little peely strips, and it doesn't help at all. The next thing I have is Advanced Clinical's Dark Circle Serum from the bougie place of Marshall's. I use such a little bit, and I can't tell if it really makes much of a difference, because I don't use it consistently. If you look at my under eyes, they're really not like shading of my skin. It's just like there's no fat under my eyes at all. It's just veins and bone. So that's why they're so dark. And the only way I can fix it is get like injections or something and no. The next thing I use, this is by The Ordinary. Let's be honest, I do not use this regularly on my face. It's hyaluronic acid, and I use it on like my chest and sometimes on my back because I get pimples there. But for the sake of the video, I just want to look like I know what I'm doing, so we're going to use it. So it was like, I didn't go to bed till like 5 o'clock in the morning, and I just kind of was going through a bunch of YouTube videos, and then I ended up watching True Crime, and then it ended in Vogue, and I don't really understand the correlation. Maybe we'll find out in 10 years, but that's fine, and then I got this idea, so here we are. Then I have this Triple Repair Moisture by Equate Beauty, literally Walmart. It says night cream, but I use it during the day because I use a different one at night. This is really nice. I put it a lot under my eyes and on my eyelids because this section is by far the driest part of my face. We're talking so dry that like in the winter time, if I'm wearing black, I could go like this and it looks like a blizzard on my hoodie from just dead skin. I also moisturize my eyebrows a lot because it's right in that general area where I get a lot of dry skin on my eyebrows too. They might be looking a little bit not symmetrical. I've never gotten them done because I'm scared that they're gonna mess them up. And I'd rather look a little unsymmetrical for my entire life than like a toenail. And then I use this CeraVe Moisturizing Cream. I use this in the parts of my face that are extra dry, like terribly Sandman horrible. The top corners of my eyes and this bridge part of my nose and my nostrils because I've got really bad allergies. So I carry tissues with me like someone's grandma and it makes my whole nose super raw and irritated. Okay, I actually think this one is expired because I think it was purchased in 2017, but shh, okay? Let me avoid my problems. I mean, you know I have sensitive skin, but I have really bad eczema too. Well, it's gotten better because I went to the Bahamas, swam in the ocean, scalded myself half to death, and been good for 6 years, but it's coming back. And it's pretty it can be pretty severe right on the lining of my lips. So I use this and I just go around like this. That is the extent of the skincare, and now I'll do the makeup. First, we're gonna have a perfume break because I have new perfumes that I'm obsessed with. My favorite one, by far, is not that one. Hold on. Is this one.
Oh my gosh.
It's by Dolce & Gabbana. It's called Devotion. I can only afford the tester bottle. It smells like rich old ladies. Oh my gosh. Frida Kahlo's, maybe. Perfect Canvas Face Primer, I actually love this. I did not purchase it. It came in like one of those, actually I have no idea. My cousin gives me most of my makeup and she gets like those monthly boxes. So I'm guessing it came out of one of those. I put it under my eyes and on top of my eyelids because that's where I wear the most of my makeup. So I'm not really a face makeup person. It's usually right in this area. So I don't actually know about the whole under eye situation. It's been dark my entire life, but I think they're getting lighter, or maybe I'm just changing my mindset because I know they're never gonna go away. I'm not really insecure about them anymore, honestly. I feel like they're just there. They're me. Like, I couldn't picture myself without them. It feels like that'd be weird. But I do have this. This is LA Girl Pro Concealer. Yes. In the shade, because we're gonna be that girl. Wait, we can't be that girl. Peach Corrector. I put on a very, very, very little bit. Like, I don't even know if you can see it. Very limited amount, because if I put it on more, it'll look horrible. Like, my face will be orange. Then I have this beauty blender. She's super dirty. I'll be honest, I have like 12 other ones. It's not a matter of getting them. It's just like, this is my emotional support beauty blender. And I don't want to get the other ones because I don't want to get them dirty. So I just live off of the fungi that's in here, I suppose. That moment when you're texting someone in the morning and they're responding, and then they text you again at noon and they're like, good morning, I wake. We were literally having a conversation at like 9. Like, did you die? I blended that, so now what I'm gonna do is I have this Ulta Beauty concealer, which I'd assume you get at Ulta Beauty, but I haven't seen it. But I don't go into Ulta Beauty because it's scary. I put like 3 or 4 dots, literally going down the lining of like the crease on my face. I don't know what that's called, but you get the point. Basically what I do is it doesn't really cover anything up, it just kind of like makes it all the same tone, because I'm pretty sure I have rosacea, I think, because my grandma does, and it's not really bad right now, but half the time, all right here will be so splotchy, and my ears will be like bright red all the time, no matter what. So I'm just trying to like make everything the same shade, and then I think after that, I don't have a problem. I gotta be honest, without sounding cocky, you're lucky I got dark under eyes, okay? Because I fear if I didn't and your girl had no dark circles, it'd be over for everybody. Now that that's done, I have this CoverGirl Clean Professional stuff. 115, I think, is what I'm supposed to be reading. When I recommend these products, it's like they're good and they'd probably be better for somebody who actually knows what's happening. So put a little bit on there. I don't know where the accent came from, that was crazy. I just put it over my makeup, which is just under my eyes, so layer some on there, like so. I guess put a little on my nose. I got like this neutral color that I put, and I try to make it all the same base shade, essentially. Then I use the white, this one, and just do like this top part of the corner, not going down here, but just this part. And like blending it into the rest of what's already there. And I really don't know if you can tell on camera, but in person it does look a little bit different. I like to like brighten them up and then add some darker makeup to, I don't know the word, but it works. Just believe, okay? Then I'll take like this one and just like dab it like once or twice and go right here. And there is pigment, I promise. And then what I'm gonna do is I take this little angle brush and I go for the darkest shade all the way, the black over here. And then just go very, very lightly. So it's like a shadow eyeliner, because I can't liquid line at all. So just like a shadow liner, and I don't go too well. I messed that up. Okay, let's try this again. I take this and I go right on the line, and I don't like overline it much, just try to stay as close to my waterline as physically possible. Very faint, very just like to complement the eyes but not take away from my actual eyes, because I love my eye color. I take this little brush, which look how pretty these are. They got like the glitter that goes through them. Like, I'm a sucker for makeup brushes that I don't use. Exhibit A. So then I take like this silver here and I put it right in the corner. So I put the glitter right in the corners there, and it makes like a little pop. Honestly, I forget that it's a fake tutorial. Vogue, come on, put me on, for real. You don't want the girl that's stuck at 104 subscribers? Like, why not? Why not? What's wrong with me? You're gonna be mad one day. If I had 1 million subs, you'd regret it. Then I got this eyelash curler, terrifying torture device. You know how many times I've got my eyelid skin stuck in there and it... I've never plucked my eyebrows, but I have plucked my eyelashes. There's one here now, and I don't do it anymore because I like how full my eyelashes look, but there's one that goes down like this, and I can't see it, you know, and it doesn't bother me. I can only see it when I look in the mirror, so it means other people can see it when they look into my eyes. And it just, it's growing downwards, and I hate it, so I used to pluck them out. Doesn't hurt as bad as you would think. Definitely not a cozy feeling, but not as bad as you would think. I just use this to brush up my eyebrows. I don't use the pencil because it doesn't work, like, it doesn't look like anything. There's no pigment, so I just use it to brush my brows into the general shape. They're close enough, right? They're like half sisters. Then what I use, funny enough, this is not actually like my favorite mascara, but I have been using it recently, Beauty For Real. So I go like that, my mascara making face. So beautiful, right? And I'm actually starting to do my lower eyelashes now, which I never used to do. I think this is definitely the first time that like I've done a makeup related YouTube video where it had the intention of coming out well. If you're a pretty girl watching my channel, you should subscribe, because I'm trying to get away from the population of dudes who watch my videos. So pretty girls, subscribe. It's very light, very, very bright pink, very baby pink. Moment of truth, take off this. I look like a psychopath. And with that, I think we're all done. So here's the end result of the makeup look. I think it looks really nice, just the natural makeup. I think it's really pretty. I'm now going to pick up my order from Taco Bell because I'm obsessed with Taco Bell and I'm starving. So if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one. Bye.